Catherine, first of all, they always say don't meet your heroes or necessarily don't work with your heroes, but I know you've loved Paul Thomas Anderson for a long time.
Yeah, too late.
was it a great experience?
Yeah, I suppose you're right. You run the risk of being really disappointed when you find out what they really like or something, and it was just the complete opposite experience on this. He's just so much more than a brilliant filmmaker. He's also an amazing man, really kind, really cool, really lovely, really self-deprecating and easy to be around. So he's just kind of one of those really annoying human beings who seems to be pretty much perfect.
How dare you be so nice? It's not fair. And talented and everything else.
Yeah, so. Certainly. I didn't remotely spoil my idea of him by working.
Did you try and find something he was terrible at? Did you try and hustle him at pool or, you know, try and find out if he was terrible at football or something?
No, but that seems like a good idea, maybe.
Yeah, take him down a bit or two. Yeah, exactly. The other thing everyone has said about him is he's an incredible collaborator, and he sort of let everyone bring their own ideas to the table. Obviously, he has his vision for the film, but he lets everybody contribute whenever you want to. Did you have anything about, you know, Shasta that you wanted to get in and you were quite happy that you managed to sort of get in the film there?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, I never felt like I had to navigate it in any way or manipulate the situation to bring the things I thought were interesting about her to the table, you know. It was just such an organic process, you know. We worked so much without discussing her, which I personally really like, you know, having some secrets and also just expressing it on film, and then if he doesn't like it or thinks it should be something different, he'll say so, you know. Mm. I can't really mark where my work started and where his finished or something, you know. We just worked together so easily in that way. That was really fun.
I know directors often give actors sort of film homework, as it were, to sort of brush up on the era, the style, that sort of thing. Did Paul say watch this or give you any advice about anything to watch before you worked on the movie?
Not really. We sort of were digging around, finding things and telling each other about them. I've always been sort of fascinated by that period ever since I was really young. Had an older brother who exposed me to music from that time, and I was sort of just fascinated with the period in which my parents were young. But I didn't know a lot about Southern California at the time, so I went to this great video store on the west side here in Los Angeles called Cinephile, and they have great old VHSs and everything, and the guys there helped me and pulled everything from right around that period, anything that was shot in Venice or around the beach, and it was really shocking to see how geographically different the LA was. At that time, there's this weird movie called The Witch Who Came from the Sea that I found. It's just about sort of a deranged woman living by the beach, but, you know, you could see Venice before it was gentrified and posh. So it was really cool to see that, and I saw some cool films. Paul did give us a movie called Mondo Hollywood, which was another one really great to see, just people living around here at the time.
You were in Eleanor Rigby, His, Hers, and now obviously Theirs. Is there a version you would prefer people watch, you know, just to get the best experience?
Well, I saw His and Hers in Toronto all together at once, and I loved that experience.